Born in 1767 in St. Thomas, located in the Eastern Caribbean Sea, a man later known as Denmark Vesey would become one of the largest figures in history.
Go down, Moses, way down in Egypt land.
Known for his failed plan to revolt against Charleston and overrun the white population, Vesey was passionate about the fight against slavery. He has become a symbol of courage and resistance, inspiring many after him to fight the injustice. Although commonly known as the mastermind behind the plan, there is evidence that says differently when looking at the court proceedings and analyzing the social construct which put African Americans in the dirt. Slavery in America created a dominant white race in which black people had no authority or power. Slavery caused a manipulative system where the words of the white men were always trusted over the black man. Many slaves were born into slavery, while others, like Denmark Vesey, were captured and brought as teenagers to become slaves in America. Many of these slaves had to endure the Middle Passage, in which over 10-15% of the slaves that forcefully took the voyage to hell died. Denmark Vesey stands as a symbol today for the man that would not endure the pain like his brothers and sisters and would rise against the system of injustice. His idea for a slave revolt has created controversy relating to the credibility of Vesey actually planning a slave revolt. Denmark Vesey's story began when he was sold into the Atlantic slave marts in the 18th century. He was bought by a slaver, Captain Joseph Vesey, where he would receive his name, Denmark Vesey, originally named Telemach. Denmark's life as a slave was better lived than most slaves during the time, because he learned and traveled the world under Captain Vesey. Vesey assisted Captain Vesey in the buying and selling of slaves throughout the Atlantic slave trade. He learned to read and write, becoming fluent in English, Spanish, and French. Vesey continued to travel with his master for 20 years, becoming a learned man and known for his physical strength. The Veseys would travel to the city of Charleston, one of the largest slave ports in North America, where Captain Vesey would retire from traveling the Atlantic. In Charleston, Vesey would begin to build his reputation amongst the other slaves and African Americans in the town. He would join the church, and in September of 1799, he would win $1,500 in the lottery. Vesey was able to buy his freedom from his master for $600 at the age of 33, after 17 years of being a slave in Charleston. He invested time and money into his carpentry business, and would take up Bible studies in 1818. Vesey and other freed blacks founded the Black Methodist Church, which gained over 3,000 members, where Vesey would be a minister. He would preach to his fellow people of color that they would soon be free from the shackles of slavery. His carpentry business was tough, competing against white men, freed mulattoes, and enslaved craftsmen. Vesey would become a well-known figure, respected by most, even the white population. Denmark Vesey is commonly painted as the leader of an insurrection, responsible for the planned deaths of thousands in the city of Charleston. He is known for getting his ideas for a revolt from the Haitian Slave Revolt, which took place from 1791 to 1804. And his constant preachings used to recruit slaves and free African Americans for the revolt. His plan called for rebels to attack guardhouses and arsenals, seize their arms, burn and destroy the city of Charleston, kill the whites, and free the slaves. The story ends with Vesey's plan being soiled by a single slave who reveals the plans to his master. Vesey was found guilty by the court. Vesey and 131 others would be tried in court, ending in the hanging of 35. The credibility and fairness of the court trial is a major factor in finding the truth about whether or not Vesey is guilty. This includes thinking about the social conflict during the time, as well as Vesey's role in the Charleston slave uprising. Vesey was a respected African-American man with influence, which from a white man's view, could become a potential threat. Everything Vesey stood for was against what white people did not tolerate in African-Americans. He had a power, a voice, and influence which made him a target. The court system was likely unjust, making the words of the slaves or black men obsolete, unless it was what they wanted to hear. Slaves could be told by their masters what to say during their testimonies, adding a factor of manipulation into why six slaves found Vesey guilty. All of the men tried in court were slaves or freed blacks. If they refused to talk or testify falsely, they would be hung. Out of the 131 men tried, 83% of them refused to testify falsely, refusing to send the blame to one of their own in order to live. The court even banned any public or press from being present during the trial. Historians have found that the court proceedings were kept in secret, and no testimony from Vesey himself can be found. The court transcript does not refer to a trial of Denmark Vesey either. The transcript indicates that the court questioned witnesses about a conspiracy and then decided that Vesey and five slaves were guilty. With minimal evidence supporting Vesey's role as the leader of the revolt, we can only see testimonies from slaves whose lives were at stake based on what they said under the control of their master's word. Theories have suggested that the whole plan was made up by the white population of Charleston. While a rebellion titled the largest and most destructive revolt of all time, the idea of a rebellion would strike fear into the hearts of white men and women. The plan could have used the public hysteria surrounding slave conspiracies to shore up political power and strengthen slavery. This would only lead to stricter laws that restricted the freedom and education of free blacks and slaves. Evidence involving an unfair court ruling poses the question, did Denmark Vesey actually plan a slave revolt? By questioning history and what we already know, we can learn more about our nation's history and the conflicts and compromises that have occurred. Although there is controversy surrounding the innocence of Denmark Vesey, he continues to live on as a symbol of resistance and courage.